This is Danica, and I build WordPress membership site. And in this series, we're working on this BodyBoss website where I'll show you how you could use BodyBoss to build your WordPress membership site. Now, do note that we are gonna integrate this with Learndash and Memberium. So if you have missed the previous video, I highly suggest you check those out, because in there I have demonstrated what plugins I have installed. Also, in the second video, I have showed you how to import the demo homepage of BodyBoss. So check that out first before you continue on this one, because this will make sense if you follow along with this series. Now, if you have any question regarding BodyBoss, feel free to comment that down below. In this series, I really want to cover those most common questions that you need to know, or you're wondering how it works. So please comment that down below, and I'll do my best to answer your question as soon as I can. So that being said, let's start this video. So in this video, we're gonna deal about your website's privacy. Now, by default, BodyBoss has this settings where you only want to allow login numbers to access your website. But since we're using Memberium, we're also going to take advantage on their functionality. And I'm going to show you the two scenarios where you could select which one will work for you. So I'll show you the first one, which is just BodyBoss side, so that just in case you don't want to use Memberium, you could still protect your website properly. And then I'll also show you the advanced one, which is with Memberium, where you could do some advanced protecting of your content. So let's get started. Okay, so in our demo site, the one that we have set up, this is incognito window. I'm not sure if you could see that properly here. If I kind of put this below, so it's in incognito window, and as you can see, I could see the sign in link, but everything is also accessible for me right now. So if I try to go to photos, I could access the photos. If I try to go to the members, I could access the members, which in most cases you may not want to do that, because again, you want to protect your members' data, keep it private. Now, in our admin side, if we check this out, you can see that the sidebar is different, right? So we have the My Connection, My Groups, My Courses. I have set up, I've showed you in the previous video how I set this up, so highly check that out. But we have different menus here. First is the login navigation, and then the second one is the non-login navigation, which is showing the different items here. You could also set different menu items later on in here for non-login members, but we're gonna discuss more of that in the next videos. So how do we protect this website? Let's do the first option, which is in BodyBoss. So if we go to our admin view here, and then navigate to BodyBoss, there is settings, and then in here there are some different things that you could set up. But if you scroll down below, you could see that there is a privacy section. Now, there's a deep tutorial in here from BodyBoss if you need to see that. So they have a video tutorial about that. So if you want to learn more about the privacy settings of BodyBoss, you could check this out. Now let's set ours. So let's go back to the settings. Scroll down to the privacy, and then check this restrict site access to only login numbers. So if we now save the settings, you could see that after saving that settings, there's a new field here that showed up. It's named Public Website content. So it says enter URLs or URI fragments to remain publicly visible always. Enter one URL or URI per line. So even if you have checked the private website and restricting the site access to only login members, you could still have some pages publicly viewed. So example, if you have some privacy policy page that you want your public users to see, or maybe a support page where they could submit a support ticket to you in case they have problem and their logins or billing information. So you could keep those pages public, and we're gonna show you how that works. But first, let's just switch to our incognito window here, and I'm gonna refresh and let's see what's different now. So from me being able to view those pages, it now changed and it pointed me to this BodyBoss login page. If I try to click terms of service, well, those are like pop-up, so you could still access those, but I could still access the forget password, which is fine. But maybe if I try to access manually the members directory, it will point me back to the login page, which is great. Now let's just say we want the public members to be available for anyone. This is just for demonstration. Please do not follow this, but I just want to show you how this public website content works. So if I enter the URL here, and maybe I'm also want to, let's just say my courses, I also want it to be public. So maybe courses. This is the default or home page of LearnDash. So let's just say I also want that. So I'm gonna enter a new line and save. I mean, paste the URL and then save settings. Let's switch to an incognito window, and I'm gonna paste the members URL here. So as you can see, I can now access this members page again. Let's try another one with the courses. So I could also access these two pages again. Now I'm gonna remove the two pages because I don't want that publicly available, and let's try to refresh after this saves. Okay, let's try it again. So the courses, if I refresh, it's now locked, and then the members, if I refresh, it's now locked. So that's how you protect your pages with BodyBoss defaults privacy setup or features. Now, do note that in here they said login and registration content will remain publicly visible. So do note on that one. Now I'm gonna turn this off and let's move to the Memberium's privacy functionality so that you could see the difference, and then you could decide how you want this to work together, or maybe just pick which one you'd like to enable, if it's BodyBoss or Memberium's privacy. But of course, if you're not using Memberium for your membership site, I just want to show you that you could still protect your website properly with BodyBoss alone. So let's just save the settings. Okay, so now let's move to the Memberium site. So let's navigate to Memberium and then settings. And then site security. In here, there is an option that says site restriction. And you can see that there is a site lock. So this is exactly the same with the BodyBoss functionality, where when enabled, all of the pages requires you to log in before you could access it. So let's just turn this to yes and update this to see how this works. Let's switch to our incognito window, and I'm gonna manually access the members site. It's still pointing me back to the login page. Now the difference is, as you can see, there is no error message like this one. It just pointed me directly to the login page. Now, since we're using Memberium here, we could override that default login page and design a different one. So, example, if I go to the login and set a login page here, that will be the redirect. That will be the page where I will be redirected to when the Memberium site lock is turned on. So, an example, if I build a page here, I'm gonna name this members login. Login form goes here. I'm just gonna put some indicator. And then I'm gonna go back to Memberium, do a refresh. Login page. Let's search for that members login page. And then let's go back to our incognito window and try to access one of the pages, which is the members, and enter. As you can see, it now pointed me to this members login page that we just created. Now you could still see the log out navigation here. That's because that's the items that we set, but let's just say we're gonna design this page in different format and have no login navigation. Then this will be your login page, and a custom one where you could put some data, maybe some graphics that you need based on your branding. So it's more customizable rather than just using this page alone. But again, this page is fine, but it's limited to the default field and information that BodyBoss provide. But if example, you're gonna use the Memberium site, you could customize this page and still keep your website private. Now, if you want to override, like example, you've enabled site lock and then you want some pages to be still available, just like what we did with BodyBoss, there's also a similar option in Memberium site. And let's just go into the page to see how this works. So example, if this is your page, well, I don't think this is a good example, so maybe I'm just gonna create a new one. So here's a sample page that I created, and let's just say you want this to be publicly available. So on the right side, there's an option here that says Memberium Content Protection, and all you need to do is click this force public option, and others, when you do that, other options are turned off because you're trying to say, I want this, I've enabled the site lock, but I want this page to be available for my public members or public viewers. So I'm gonna click the force public, and before I do that, let's just let's preview this. Page here in our incognito window, just so you could see the difference. It's still pointing me to the members login page that I created, but when I save this, and because I set this to force public, I save this. And let's go back to our incognito window. Try to paste that in the same page, sample page one. And now if I click that or enter that, it's now allowing me to view this page. So example, if I say page and refresh, I can see all the content on this page. And that's because we have set it to force public. And that's because we have set this to force public. So I hope this video helps in your setup for deciding how to protect your website properly. Whether you're just using BodyBoss alone or maybe integrating it with Memberium, then you have two options. But what's important is they give you this ability to protect your website and keep your content private. So they give you this option to protect your content as well as allowing some of your pages to be viewed publicly whenever you need to, depending on your setup. If you find this video helpful, please click that subscribe button and then the ring bell so that you get notified whenever I upload WordPress membership site videos like this. And of course, if you have any question, please comment it down below and I'll do my best to answer those as soon as I can. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!